Hi everybody, winter is here and it's time for our top five winter golf tips.
Oh, come on, get in there. Roll out.
Can't roll out in the winter.
Let's take charge of your game. Thank you for joining us, everybody. And as you can see, it is winter, the mitts are out, the frost's on the ground, and we are all wrapped up. And today we're going to be sharing our top five winter golf tips. Now, we're going to start on the teeing ground. Now, I've got a lot of questions, Pierce, lately from the guys just saying, look, what do you do in this condition through the winter? What do you do in this condition? So we're answering this, our top five winter golf tips. Now, if you want to get involved and have your question answered, then please leave a comment or your question down below. We'll pick a winner and we will choose one pretty much each week where we can answer. So Pierce, winter golf, it changes. Yes. We know it changes a lot because of the conditions and things like that. So we're going to bring five, but let's start on the teeing ground. We're on the 17th at Purton here. Now, normally when we play this hole, the two iron comes out.
Two iron, three iron.
We want to get it in play.
Yeah.
But you've got the driver. Talk us through why you've got the driver and why it changes through the winter.
It's pretty simple, really. It's all about carry in the winter. The ball we know isn't going to run too much. So as you said, Andy, this fairway is quite tight. It's about 20 yards wide. We've got trees left, trees right, and a bunker on the right. So the thing is, if I hit my driver 15 yards offline in the summer, it'll pitch on the left side of the fairway or the left semi-rough, and it will go into the trees. I'm going to be dead. Same on the right. But if I hit a driver now and I pitch it 15 yards off my target, it's going to pitch in the left-hand semi and it'll still be fine. So because the golf ball is going to stop quickly, it obviously makes you a lot more accurate. It adds length to the hole, which is another reason why you should hit driver and go for the long ball. But it's definitely going to make it a lot more accurate for you because you haven't got to think about the run.
Definitely. We know in the summer it plays shorter. We've got a lot of roll, especially on the firm fairways here. So it just means that we can be a little bit more aggressive off the tee and without the fear of it really bouncing out into the trouble, isn't it, really?
And why would you want to hit a two iron in the winter and you thin it?
Exactly. It's much bigger head, that one, isn't it? Much bigger head. Okay, so let's fire one away, Pierce.
Okay.
So what we're saying on this one then, guys, in the winter, be a little bit more aggressive off the tee because you can get further down there. We need the distance. But be more aggressive because even a bad shot is going to be more in play.
Okay. The other thing that I would say on this shot for me, I'm definitely going to be more right side of the fairway because if I miss on the right, the trees aren't as thick as they are on the left.
So we've moved to the fairway approach shots. Now, this is where it catches everybody out. People think that they get a little bit weaker over the winter. They think, I've lost distance off my irons. So what we're going to do is talk about this scenario here. Pierce is a really lovely drive, split the fairway, 157 yards to the flag. Now, there's two main things, Pierce, that really affect the distance in the winter, because this is the key thing, isn't it? We've got the temperature, obviously goes
of
colder,
course,
which really affects the distance. But then we've got the land and the roll. Now, talk us through the scenario we've got here in the summer, and then how it plays out now.
Okay, so we've got 157 yards to the flag. Now, because the green slopes from front to back, so it's sloping away from me, it means that generally when we play this hole in the summer, we've got to actually hit it short of the green. So I've probably got to hit it around about 135 to 140. So I'm pitching it maybe 5 yards short of the green to then allow it to roll down towards the flag, hopefully. Now, if I do that now and pitch it at 135, it's going 136 at most. So I now am able with the conditions to land this golf ball all the way up to the flag. So straight away now, normally in the summer it's a pitching wedge, the 135 to 140. Now it's probably an 8-iron to get it up there by the flag. And as you say, be mindful of the conditions as well. If it's really, really cold, it could even go up to a 7-iron.
Well, exactly. So not only is the carry distance less, but also we have to take into account in the summer the bounce and the roll, where that isn't really a factor now.
Don't really get it.
So we really can just go, what's the distance to the flag? It's 157,
yes,
maybe club up because of the cold, and then just fire it straight, not necessarily at the flag, but maybe at the right distance that you're looking for.
Yeah.
Now, Pierce, are you going to go at the flag on this one?
Going to go at the flag. The one thing I will say on this one as well, actually, if you were in the rough, then it may be a club more because the rough gets wet and it can be sometimes sitting down on a bare lie, so you may even have to go with even more club if you're in the rough, but again, you've got to manage that, whether you can get the golf ball out of the rough. But yeah, on this shot here as well, and one other thing, Andy, before I hit this one, we can take advantage of placing.
Yeah.
You wouldn't believe how many pro-ams I've played in over the years when you can place and people have just cleaned their ball and just dropped it back on the floor. Put it in a nice place. Sit it up a little bit if you need to. Take advantage of that rule.
Definitely.
So as you said, I'm going to go out this flag, but that means I'm going to have to go a little bit right, a little bit of right to left wind. So I'm going to go a little bit right of the flag and let the wind drift it into the flag.
Such a key thing this time of the year. If you're enjoying the video, guys, as well, don't forget to hit the like and let us know in the comments down below. Very nice. Now, if you're in the UK and you play golf in the winter, you definitely get faced with these bunker shots where it's very wet, it's very compact, and it's hard sand. So it presents a different challenge. We need to play it very differently. Now, in this situation, Pierce, obviously, in a normal bunker where it's fluffy, we'd have the face wide open. How do we approach this? I know we've got a tight shot, by the way.
We haven't got a lot of room there, have we?
How do we approach this in terms of how we set up and swing?
Yeah, I mean, look, so the first thing we've had to do here is, because the bunkers aren't too bad here at Purton Park, we've actually had to scrape this out a little bit to try and get rid of the sand. But yeah, the thing that we need to be mindful of is the main benefit or the main helper when we're in these bunkers is the bounce angle. Now, when the sand gets really compacted, the bounce angle isn't so much our friend. So the first thing you can do is you can actually go towards a lower bounce on your club selection if you want to. But the next thing we need to bear in mind is that we want to get the club face, as opposed to laying it wide open like we normally would, Andy, we want to actually feel as though the face is open, but not as much open. So it almost feels as though it's just a little bit open. Now, I know people watching this will say straight away, well, isn't it going to come out a little bit lower? What about the lip? Well, that's when you need to get out with your 60 degree. But if you've got one of those, if you haven't, then you should get one of those. But the next thing you need to understand is when the ball hits the ground, because the sand is wet and because the grass is wet out there, it's probably going to stop a lot quicker as a result of that. Yeah, so that's a good thing. So we're taking away, we're adding a little bit of distance almost to the shot by not having the face so open, but we're getting it back by the ball stopping quicker.
Definitely. And the good thing about your highest loft, it generally has the lowest bounce. So if you've got a 60 degree, it might be a low bounce as well. So we're really getting the leading edge and digging it in the sand, which is really just going to help the ball come out.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the thing for me as well, this, and when it comes to the technique, it's all about your preferences really on this one. But one technique that works really well with a lot of golfers and with myself is that instead of when we're opening the face and they're creating lots of wrist angles on the way back to then throw the loft underneath the ball on the way down, you could actually try not using the wrist so much. So you could actually stand there now, face slightly open, then put my hands on the golf club. And then on the way back, just feel as though the club, you don't get so much wrist set on the way back. And yes, of course, you had the loft on the way through, keeping the loft almost pointing towards my face, but you're not sort of excessive with these wrist angles. So it's almost feeling as though the wrists are taken out of the shot, almost like a Molinari type of bunker shot.
I mean, it definitely looks more body orientated there. It's sort of more governed by this. Everything's working together as opposed to aggressively throwing that, sort of accelerating that club past the body. Well, I've seen this work for you, Pierce, numerous times now. You've done this a few shots over the last few weeks. So
are you saying I keep going in the bunkers?
No, not at all, So let's see if you can get this one close.
Okay, it's a pretty tricky one, isn't it? There's not a lot of room there, but let's see what happens to the contact and see what happens to the ball when it hits the ground. Oh, well, nearly.
That's exactly how you play. So look, you've done that quite a lot over the little one.
Told you it would stop quickly.
It did stop quickly. It's a good job. But look, that's how you play that one there. Some simple tips. Keep the face square, a little bit less wrists. Experiment with it. That just might help you.
Right then, Andy, it's your turn. So chipping in the winter is definitely tricky. Wet, muddy lies. What sort of things are we looking for? Because it changes things up massively, doesn't it?
It does with the strategy, yeah. And this is where a lot of people get really nervy on these shots because the ground is so soft and we get those horrible duff shots potentially. But yeah, let's talk about the strategy first. Well, in the summer, and we've got a 34-yard shot here, Pierce. The flag's obviously way to the back of the green. In the summer, my landing zone for this shot for me would be 52 degree. I use my 52 degree to chip with. Now, my landing zone would probably be 15 yards on. So that allows me to pitch it, sort of land, roll, and sort of maybe just slow down a little bit. But let's say it's almost halfway to the flag there. Now, in this situation, my landing zone now is probably going to be somewhere close to maybe 28 to 30 yards, nearly all the way there. So we don't have that land, we don't have that roll, just like obviously the full shot that we played earlier, Pierce. So now it's totally different. Instead of looking at my landing zone pretty close, I've got to fly it all the way, which is sometimes hard because if we get the strike a little bit off, it's a little bit dangerous. Okay. But this is where the technique as well comes into it. So first of all, landing zone, project your thoughts a little bit closer to the flag where we've got to fly it there, it's going to stop. Probably even leave a pitch mark on some of these shots as well.
Yeah. Okay, so interesting as well. It's well worth walking the journey. So it's well worth walking out there and looking where you want to land the golf ball and making sure it's not super, super soft and it's just going to plug, because it can happen. And here it's actually quite wet by the green.
I'm just going to play one shot.
Yeah.
I'm just going to play one to the 15-yard spot where I would normally land it in the summer. And let's just see what happens here. So I'm just looking at where I want to land this and we'll just see what happens to the ball. Okay, one bounce. And it's gone probably, you know, two-thirds of the way.
Yeah, rolls out about 8 yards, that's all.
Two thirds away. And then the summer, that would have been pretty good. I landed it exactly where I wanted to, but it's obviously way short, okay. Short now. So I need to fly it all the way.
So we know you want to fly it all the way. So what are you going to do with the technique, though, to avoid this duff shot?
In the wet, muddy lies, this is what we see people do. They're scared because often this club digs in and the ball goes nowhere. But that's often because they are exposing the leading edge. They are leaning the shaft forward. They're getting the golf ball back because they want to make sure that they strike the golf ball first. And it often happens that they get this duff shot, they move the ball even further back and try and hit more down, which is more of a disaster. We often see then this club just getting stuck in the ground, loads of turf, it sort of cuts into the turf there, and that really is disastrous for the shot. We want to, and we talk about this all the time, we want to expose the bounce angle so it can glide and slide along the turf as good as possible and reduce any digging in. Notice what I'm doing with the shaft here. To get expose the bounce, the shaft is leaning back. So that's what I'm going to do in my setup. Ball's going to be middle to even slightly forward, and I'm going to lean the shaft pretty neutral here, and I'm making sure that I haven't got loads of wrists. From here now, I'm just allowing the club to brush along the ground. You'll see hardly any turf. I can feel the bottom of the club just glide and slide along the wet surface, and that really is going to be so much more consistent.
Yeah, absolutely. So the one thing we would say is that obviously this is off the fairway. If you're in the rough, you need to be obviously bear in mind what the lie is like. If the lie is good, then you can do the same as what Andy's saying here. If the lie is sitting down a little bit in the rough, you probably need to put the ball a little bit further back and you need to lean the shaft forward. But you can still have the same mindset on where the ball lands because it's still going to stop very quickly. So chipping out the rough in the winter, as long as you get the right sort of thought process, actually isn't that difficult.
Right, so now I'm just going to match my length swing to exactly where I want that ball to land now, which is pretty close to the flag pierce, maybe 5 or 6 yards short of that flag.
I think you can land it 5 yards short. So Andy, right, we're on the putting green now. Tip 5, similar to what we had with the chip shot, we need to bear in mind what the ground conditions are like, obviously, when we're playing this shot, as with all the tips really. But for sure, it's going to be slower. Generally, the greens in the winter are going to be slower. And like we did with the chip shot, you want to make sure that you are walking up and feeling the ground and understanding what the ground is like, because you don't want to be going through any puddles when you're doing this. But what happens, Andy? We know it's going to be slower. What happens to the break? Does that change?
Yeah, definitely. Well, look, I think there's lots of different things. These greens here have been hollow tines, so there's holes in the greens. We get a lot more footprints because it's wet. There's going to be less break because the greens are slower. So it means that we don't have to allow for as much break. It also means we can be a little bit more aggressive with the shot as well, because it's going to slow down quickly. We know in the summer when we're getting those fast, slippery greens, we have to be a little bit more tentative because it sort of gets past the hole and it continues to go. Well, this now is going to slow down quite quickly. So it means that we, even on the longer putts, it means we can be a little bit more aggressive. And it's nice to have that mentality as well when we approach with, let's say, a 20-footer.
I definitely think this is worth asking yourself this question now. The last time you played golf when the greens were in this winter state, how many times did you leave the ball short? How many times did you leave the ball short of the hole? I'm guessing that the majority of your putts, you would have left it short.
A lot. So I've got to get this pass now. That's a good.
I've primed him ready.
So there's not much break in this. It's going to break a little off the right, not loads. So but I'm really going to focus on hitting this pretty aggressively just outside the right lip here.
It's interesting that we often say that people underread their putts, Andy, in the summer on the faster greens, but maybe in the winter they get them just about right.
Yeah, not a bad thing, is it? Okay, a little bit more of an aggressive stroke here. Just off the right edge. Just got to get it past the hole, or in, obviously, Pierce.
Okay.
Okay, a little too aggressive on that one.
Well, the good thing is that I'm not going to go to the other side. Well, we'll bring the ball actually this side. Let's have a go at the short putt from this side. So let's bring it back into here, Andy. Let's just go to here. Now, as you said, footprints could be a problem. The impurities in the greens. The greens are pretty good here, but it makes sense that they're going to mark up. The holes, they can actually get damaged as well a little bit more. So you need to bear in mind that all these things can be going on. So Andy should only really be looking here.
And I know there's not much break on that now. So all I'm really going to do, even on these short putts here, because of the inconsistency in the surface, if I sort of trickle it in there, it's got much more chance of rolling off. So I'm really going to hit this at the back of the hole with a little bit of a pop. You know, like Tiger hits these putts, Pierce, and he's got this bit of a pop here. It's hitting that back of the hole. Nice and positive on these. I don't want it sort of moving away. Taking the break out of it there. And you can see how aggressive that was. But on these, we want to make sure that we can get that working, because it's so easy on these small ones during the winter, just miss it right, miss it left, and then we're really annoying.
You're doddling them around the hole almost, exactly. Leaning it short and then doddling it around the hole. Look, I hope you enjoyed that. Now, we have got three amazing coaching plans, Break 100, Break 90, Break 80. We cover a lot of this course management stuff, as well as helping you to change your golf swing to help you break that landmark score. We hope you enjoyed the video. Please post your comments down below, as we said, and we'll see you soon.